This is a right sided fibula. How can we identify it? First we have to go into the lower end, then we have to show a triangular part. This is the triangular part. Its apex will follow the apex upwards like this, and it will form the anterior border. So we'll keep it like this in the anterior surface. And how can we identify another point is, we have to see the articular surface in the lower end. This is the articular surface. We have to keep it medially. So anterior border and articular surface medially, it will be right fibula. Now parts of the fibula are upper end, neck, shaft and lower end. Upper end consists of an articular surface and a bony elevation, which is the styloid process, and a groove. Articular surface articulates with the fibula to form the tibiofibular joint, which is a plane type of synovial joint. Then on the bony ridge, there is attachment of the insertion of the biceps femoris muscle. And in the slopy bony area, bony elevation, it is a styloid process, which mainly gives insertion, which is attached to the fibular collateral ligament. Now the shaft. Shaft has borders and surfaces. First of all, following this triangular line, this is the anterior border. Then this part, just medial to it, this is the medial border. And this one, it is the posterior border. And in between then, this one is the medial crest. It is not to be confused with the medial border. First is the anterior border here, then there is the medial border, and there is the posterior border. So three borders and surfaces are between anterior border and medial border, there is medial surface. Between medial border and the posterior border, including the medial crest, it is whole is posterior surface. And between anterior border, this one, and the posterior border, this is the lateral surface. Now attachments of the medial surface. First of all, medial surface gives attachments of the extensor group, extensor compartment of the leg. That is the extensor hallucis longus, extensor digitorum longus, and peroneus tertius. Then in the posterior surface, in the medial between the then in the medial surface, that is between medial border and posterior border, we have the three muscles attachments, which are the muscles of the posterior compartment of the leg. That is, first of all, in the groove, there is tibialis posterior muscle, and in the upper 1/4 there is soleus muscle, and in the lower 3/4 there is flexor hallucis longus. Now lateral surface, as the name suggests, lateral surface means the lateral compartment of the leg. There is a peroneus longus in the upper part, going extending up to the 1/3, lower 1/3, and peroneus brevis going extending upwards to the 1/3. Peroneus longus extends up to the lower 1/3, and peroneus brevis in the lower part extends up to the upper 1/3. Border is, there is in the anterior border, there is attachment of the anterior intermuscular septum. Medial border, it is the interosseous border, which is the attachment of the interosseous membrane, and in the posterior border, there is lateral intermuscular system. Now the lower end has, this is the medial surface, this is the lateral surface, this is the anterior border, and this is the tip. Now first of all, there is medial surface. Medial surface has many convolutions. So first of all, there is articular surface, which articulates with the fibula, inferior tibiofibular joint, which is a syndesmosis type of synovial joint, fibrous joint. Then there is malleolar fossa, and there is a groove between malleolar fossa and articular surface. This groove gives attachment of the tendon of peroneus brevis and peroneus longus. That is, now here is the malleolar fossa. In the upper part, there is attachment of the inferior transverse tibiofibular ligament, and in the lower part, there is calcaneofibular ligament. Then anterior border, here is the posterior calcaneofibular ligament. So in the anterior border, as the name suggests, anterior tibiofibular ligament, calcaneofibular ligament, anterior talofibular ligament. Sab ulta bol raha hu.
Three.
Once again the malleolar fossa. In the upper part there is inferior transverse tibiofibular ligament. In the lower part there is talofibular ligament, posterior talofibular ligament. In the anterior border, as the name suggests, there is anterior talofibular ligament. And in the notch, here is the notch. There is the first talus bone, then calcaneum bone. So, calcaneofibular ligament. Now, in the medial crest, we can see the nutrient foramen. This is a nutrient foramen. And as it is located in the downward side, so growing end will be the upper end.